Well, I was kind of hoping not to buy a lot. I mean, I already knew which ones I wanted to get, and those were the ones I was sort of looking to get, and I got some of them. Others were lost, but I kind of think I might have went overboard. Just a bit. In case you didn't know, as of Good Friday, what I believe to be the last HMV store in southern Ontario and perhaps all of Canada has closed. The downtown superstore at Yonge and Dundas is now closed as of me filming this video, because Good Friday is over. HMV is no longer in Canada that I know of. Make sure you stay to the end of the video in order to see the really big item I picked up. I'm saving it for last. It's really big. And it's not a Blu-ray or a DVD. So, ooh, what could it be? Stay tuned to the end of the video to find out. Here is what I bought at HMV. As you can see, you know, I haven't bought enough Blu-rays. So I obviously need more. These are the things I bought when it was at 60% off. Are you ready for this? Of course you're ready for this. You clicked on the video. I got The New Frontier. Never seen it. Never heard of it. See, my mom is a big John Wayne fan. Except for the movies where his character dies. And his younger work that's before Stagecoach. You know what? I'm very interested in seeing his earlier works. It kind of bugs my mom a bit. I mean, these aren't exactly Western classics, but they are, you know, old. John Wayne, The New Frontier. John Wayne, King of the Pesos. Never seen it. Let's pull out this trilogy. Well, I think it's a trilogy. I don't know. I don't know how many they made, but apparently John Wayne was in a couple of films as part of a trio called the Free Mesquiters. I'm not sure how to pronounce that. And so I picked up, all the ones I could find. So you got Frontier Horizon, not to be confused with The New Horizon. And then you got Overland Stage Raiders. Yeah, that sounds cool. And then you also got John Wayne, The Knight Riders. Yeah, so it looks like it's sort of like a Free Musketeers of Westerns, so I'm quite excited to see those movies for the first time. Gotham Season 2. Well, obviously it's the complete Season 2. I picked up the first one beforehand, way before HMV was closing. HMV had a really nice... like, it's like a metal tin. I kind of like that addition. I was kind of hoping they were going to do it for the second one. They never did. So I decided to pick this up because it was dirt cheap. It's really the only DC show that I've been following up to a certain point, but then I sort of forgot about it. So I only was like a couple episodes into season two or something like that. Yeah, like 5 or 10 episodes. I forget how many episodes I was in, but... I still want to continue watching this. I want to continue watching the other DC shows, but this is the only one where I don't have to worry about watching another show in order to continue. Like, that's the problem with Arrow and The Flash and Supergirl and whatever, Heroes of Tomorrow or whatever, is the crossover episodes are the things that keeps me away from watching them because I want to watch it in order, and I don't know what order to watch it in. So Gotham was nice because, you know, it may have a couple references or timbits, but it's nothing directly related because it takes place when, you know, assumingly everyone would have been younger. So that's enough of a rant on Gotham. I picked up, I heard about this series. I really wanted to watch it. I picked up season 1 and season 2 of The Nick. I'm really excited to watch this. I've heard it's very good. And this one has the HMV exclusive bonus disc about scoring The Nick. So that's cool. HMV exclusive on the season 1. And, you know, dirt cheap. I'll take a chance on this series, you know? Always liked watching Clive Owen, but there's not many movies and TV shows that I've seen him in. This one was a very good deal. 3D movies. Goosebumps. I always liked the original books and all that. I sort of grew out of the books and the TV show. I watched a couple episodes and I enjoyed it. So, when I saw a trailer for this, it was kind of, yeah, I'm like, okay, it's Hollywood trying to cash it on something. I never seen it, so I hope it's good. I mean, for the price, I'm not really complaining if it turns out to be a bad movie. I mean, at the very least, you got Jack Black, so. I picked up Birth of a Nation. Not the original Birth of a Nation. This is the newer, technically, I guess you would call it a remake. I don't know, I haven't seen it. I wanted to pick it up before the sleeve goes, because this goes with the, because 20th Century Fox has been doing these sleeves where it opens up and there's usually just a nice picture and then stuff. So I wanted to get this before the sleeve goes out, so I lucked in. I picked up because I was recommended that this to watch this movie. Love and Friendship. Not exactly a movie I would really just off the top of my head from what, because I haven't seen the trailer, I haven't seen the movie, just off the title is kind of a movie I would generally avoid, but apparently it's really good, and it's based off of Jane Austen's work, so I definitely am interested in seeing this movie. We got Liam Neeson in Nonstop. I saw this in the theaters, and I was like, you know, I kind of liked it. It was decent. It was nothing spectacular, but it's better than Taken 2 and 3. I'll say that right there. And, you know, price was unbeatable. Why did that sounded like I was saying a bad pun? Now I picked up Demolition with Jake Gyllenhaal. Another movie I heard was very good. I saw the trailer for it, and I really liked the trailer. I was thinking of seeing it, but, you know, it sort of fell out of my mind. It has the sleeve. I'm like, yeah, I'll pick it up. Definitely enjoy seeing Jake Gyllenhaal act. I also picked up Cell with John Cusack and Samuel L. Jackson. I mean, first of all, that cast, great. It's based off of Stanley Kubrick. It's based off the Stephen King book of the same name. So I'm super excited. I mean, I haven't read the book. I haven't seen the movie. I haven't even seen the trailer for this. But, you know, I know the plot. It's something to do with cell phones and how it causes the end of the world. So that's basically it. So I'm kind of excited to watch this. Okay, I picked up Arrested Development Season 4, because I've had the first three seasons for a long time, and, you know, they released it for Netflix, and I was like, oh, I need to marathon it one day. I haven't got around to it. So I still haven't seen Season 4, and then it came out, and I was like, okay, I'll just wait for it to pick it up, and I waited so long, HMV went out of business, and was selling it at dirt cheap prices. Woo! Next up, we got Let's Be Cops. Yeah, I mean, this was kind of a movie I wasn't expecting to be good. I saw it in theaters, and I was pleasantly surprised by this movie. It was actually funny. It was actually, you know, considering the low budget nature of this film, it was really good. I enjoyed it. Now the one mistake I did, because HMV wants to you know, get as much money out of the things as possible as they're leaving. They canceled your point card, Pure Points card, in case you didn't know. Literally the week of the announcement that they're going to be out of Canada by the end of April. So I had a lot of points. I didn't have a lot of points, but I still had a decent amount of points, and I kind of wish I was able to redeem those, but HMV was like, no, we just won't accept it, you know? So, sorry, too bad, you should have spent it beforehand, which is unfortunate. And then I found out that anything with a green sticker is full price. None of the discounts affects it. And I was like, damn it, HMV. Son of a... So, I picked this up thinking it was going to be part of the sale, and it turned out until afterwards when I was leaving the store and looking at the receipt that it wasn't. So, I picked up Dragonfly Squadron. And it's a really old film, 1953, and it's in 3D, but I'm not sure. It doesn't tell me if it's the newer 3D or the older 3D. Either way, I'm able to handle it because I have a 3D TV. But I'm still a little pissed off, you know, it wasn't 60% like it should have been. So, but there's nothing I can do, especially now. This one took a chance on because I can't believe there's a movie starring Mick Jagger. It's called Ned Kelly. For some reason, that name sticks out for me. I've never seen the film. I don't even know what it's about. It looks like it's something to do with guns, violence, and some guy who looks like he's half armored or something. So, I have no idea what this is about, but you got Mick Jagger. I'm like, he can act? I don't know, I haven't seen the film. Well, I wanted to see this movie in theaters, didn't get a chance, and I didn't really want to pick it up because afterwards I heard that the animation department did not get properly credited for all the work they'd done, and apparently it was a very, very horrible work place or something like that. I don't know. It was sort of sketchy, but I kind of really wanted to see it. It was Sausage Party. And since it was so cheap, I figured, you know, they already made money off of the film with the amount of people seeing it in theaters and buying it. So I heard from several family members it was really good, so I can't wait to watch it. This movie I wanted to pick up for a while. I heard it was, just the premise alone, you've got a horror film that involves the editor. Yeah, really excited to watch this film. It's like I remember seeing a little bit of the trailer, and I was like, this is like gruesome and low budget type horror film, and it's based around an editor for filmmaking, so I'm like, yeah, count me in. This one was cool, picking up. Always wanted to see it, always heard about it, never actually seen it, is Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon. And it's the Supreme Cinema Series edition, which I've never picked up before of any other movie. I don't know, is it like a... It looks like a weird digibook. That's what it looks like, so... definitely interested to open that up, and plus, I never saw the movie. Heard it's really good. Okay, and then I went on a Nicolas Cage marathon of picking up Pay the Ghost. Never heard of it. Never seen it. Nicolas Cage is in it. That's all I needed to know. The Trust with Nicolas Cage and Elijah Wood. Nicolas Cage, dare I say more. Army of One with Nicolas Cage and Russell Brand. Nicolas Cage, dare I say more. And he looks like he's riding a donkey. I don't know why. I'll find out when I watch the film. This one I lucked out on. This one I actually found one with a slipcover, and I definitely did not want to leave it behind. Mm-hmm. I made sure this one wasn't left behind. I just... Puns. I'll leave. And the final Nicolas Cage one I picked up. Despite all my rage, I'm still just Nicolas Cage. I don't know. Reveal that. This one I sort of needed to get just the complete 2 for $20. I was missing one more 2 for $20, and I asked my mom because I heard about this title, but I don't know if it's a good movie or not, and she said it was a really good movie, so I'll pick it up. Is P.S. I Love You. I've heard that name sticks out. I've heard that name a lot, and it's considered a good movie, so I'm like, I'll pick it up. I wanted to pick up, I heard this was a really bad movie audio edit-wise, and maybe a little bit editing-wise, but I kind of wanted to see it just because it's one of Paul Walker's last films, is Brick Mansions. And then this movie, I love this movie, it's unfortunate how bad the second one was. I've never seen the second one, but I've heard it's so bad. But the first one is a treasure, and I love it. I totally forgot about it for my top 100 favorite movies list, is Hoodwinked. But I really loved how they twisted the original little stories and made its own thing. Lots of references to other things. I love this film. So I definitely had to pick it up. I picked up RV. Robin Williams. I'm trying to find all the Robin Williams films, and this one I found, so I was like, yes, gotta get it. I also picked up Capote. I think that's how you pronounce it. Capote. I'm sorry, I'm really bad with names and pronunciations. Heard this is a really good film. Philip Seymour Hoffman won Best Actor for his role. I believe this is based on a real person. I'm very interested in watching this film. I picked up The Corner Gas, the movie. I saw this on television a couple of months ago, about 6 or 8 months ago. I was like, I should definitely pick this up eventually because I have the rest of the TV series on DVD. So I'm like, I should get the movie on Blu-ray. Yeah, and I did. Oh, I also decided to pick up Man on a Ledge. I remember seeing the trailers for this in theaters when it came out, but I never watched it. It looked a little generic. But I don't know, with that casting, I was like, you know what, I'll take a chance for the price. I can't believe I found this when I did, and unfortunately the disc is rattling around, so I'm not gonna shake it around as much, but I picked up Psycho 4, The Beginning. Really don't like the sound of the disc rolling around. I wanted the slipcover, but Scream Factory never made a slipcover for this, which is really unfortunate because it's like you have one for Psycho 2 and you have it for Psycho 3. And so now Psycho 4 will have to not have a cover because they never made a cover. So I was like, for dirt cheap, I really hope the disc is not damaged. Hopefully that movie still works. I picked up with the slipcover The Woman in Black 2. I loved the first Woman in Black. I saw that in theaters. I loved it. Second one, well, you know, horror films generally sequels. I don't know if it's good or not. I don't know where the film goes afterwards. I've never seen it. But I'm like, I'm going to pick it up because I want to see what they did next with this. So, hopefully it's as good as the first one. The thing I want to actually note is the slipcover. It's the normal smooth feeling, but the hands are like a different fabric or different material, and that's really cool. I'm really glad I got this with the slipcover. So glad I was able to find it with the slipcover. With 60% off, the things were flying off the shelves. Flying off the shelves. It was complete utter chaos in HMV. There was people fighting and pushing and people were grabbing stuff and trying to get all the deals and fighting other people for it. It was crazy. It was utter chaos. And this movie I was going to get, I looked and they had so many copies, but they had none with the sleeve or slip cover. And I was like, if I'm going to get it, I'm going to get it with the slip cover. And then I went to another section. I went to, like, TV section, a section where it shouldn't be. And I found there was one sitting there with the slip cover. I couldn't believe it. Zoolander number 2. And, you know, I heard it was really bad. I never actually went to see it. I did enjoy the first one, but not as much as I think everyone else says they enjoyed it. It's like everyone was like, oh, it's like really good. It's the best movie. And I'm like, it was decent. It was really, it had its funny moments, and I really liked it overall, but it wasn't as great as a movie as I thought. And the second one came out, and everyone was like, oh, this is horrible. So I was like, I'm going to pick it up because it's cheap. And it came with the slipcover, so I was like, yes, I grabbed it as soon as I could. The final thing I picked up at 60% off was Popstar, Never Stop Stopping. Oh, man. Apparently, it was a really good satire of the pop music industry. And you got the Lonely Island, and I'm like, yeah, I'll get this. It's cheap, and it came with a slipcover. So I'm like, yes, I'm definitely getting that. Can't wait to watch this. Now, for the next park, I got things at around 80-85% off. Like, it was in between. It was a little weird chaos in the HMV. So, stay tuned. Because when we return, 80-85% off. What did I buy? Okay, and now we're back. 80-85% off. What did I get? Actually, it was such a big deal that anything that was like 2 for 10... 2 for 5, 2 for 10, 2 for 15, 2 for whatever the price of 2/whatever. It was $5 for $15. That's like $3 a film. And I'm like, yes, I gotta pick up some things. Even the things I'm like, I'm not too keen about. But you know what, for that price... Gotta get it. Gotta get them all. So I picked up Phone Booth. I love this film. The only thing I disliked is when I got around to seeing it, I've already knew the very recognizable Kiefer Sutherland voice. So it's very hard to keep this a secret of who the bad guy is. The only problem I had with this movie is because it would have been cool not knowing who the bad guy is. I kind of wish he wasn't, you know, like he's even on the case. Look, there's a picture of him, and it even says, and Kiefer Sutherland. So, I never really wanted to pick up these things, but I was like, you know what? It would be nice having one, like, on my editing desk as I edit. So, I decided to pick up, because there was a ton of them. There was an army of them. I picked up Agent Coulson pop Marvel vinyl figure or whatever. I don't know what it's called. Pop figure. I think that's what they call these things. Pop figures. Agent Coulson. Awesome. Now I have Agent Coulson watching me as I work, and I'll just pretend he's like, Mitchell, you're working for S.H.I.E.L.D. now, you know, editing stuff.
I'm aware of that, sir.
Apparently it's a bobblehead. I don't know, because I'm looking at it, it's like a little spring. So, it's also a bobblehead. I'll put that over there. I picked up Taxi. I remember really enjoying this film, but it's been a very long time since I've seen it. So, Can't wait to watch it. Can't wait to rewatch it. I picked up The Sentinel. Never heard of it. Michael Douglas is in it and Kiefer Sutherland. Okay. I'll see that movie. I'll see that movie 9 times out of 10. I don't know what that meant. Okay, anyways. This next movie, I just have to show you it because that's enough said. Yeah, Mitchell, you're just really clever with this. One of the last films James Gandolfini. I probably butchered that name. I'm very sorry. That's one of his last films. I picked up the phenomenon known as Mr. and Mrs. Smith. Always wanted to see it. Apparently it's very good action-wise. And, The Simpsons parodied it. So, I think I kind of know what the story's going to happen in it, but I'm not sure if it's totally spoiled, so I'm pretty sure there's probably enough new elements I haven't seen before. I picked up Rollerblade. I'm taking a total 100% chance. I mean, it's a film with rollerblades, it looks like, and it's action. So, I don't know, are they like fighting to the death? I have no idea. It's Rollerblade. I'm excited. A movie on rollerblades. Awesome. This movie I never heard of, but I really like Inception. What's the chances of me liking Deception? It's with Hugh Jackman, Ewan McGregor, and Michelle Williams. So I'm like, yes, gotta see this. I have no idea what it's about. I assume it has some sort of deception to it. Anyways, I also picked up Runner Runner. I heard it was decent. So I'm like, oh, I'll take a chance. This movie, for some reason, the name really stuck out for me. And I don't know why, but On the Riviera with Danny Kaye. So it's an older musical type movie. So I'm interested in seeing it. So I picked up some Denzel Washington films, such as The Siege, Man on Fire, and Courage Under Fire. Like, wow. Apparently all three of these movies are very good. So I can't wait to watch them. And we're down to the last stack. Lost count of how many things I got. I picked up Piranha and Piranha Double D. I believe this is a remake of an older movie called Piranha, and then this is the sequel to the remake. I know David Hasselhoff is in this one, so I'm definitely excited to watch both of these. It's a monster movie I'm looking forward to, you know? I picked up Valkyrie with Tom Cruise. I always heard about this film, but I never saw it. I don't know if it's good, but I am interested in seeing it. Apparently it's based on a true story, you know? I also picked up, unfortunately I didn't get the slipcover, but for the price, am I complaining? The Incredible Burt Wonderstone. Yes, I said the title correctly. I'm surprised. The Heat. Apparently it's very funny, and apparently it's very good. I have to see it, so can't wait to watch that. I love music, love movies about music, and Nina. I know there was some, there was definitely some news around this movie, but, you know, for the price, not complaining. Once again, can't wait to watch it. This movie I never heard of, but I had to get it just because of the cast. You got Liam Hemsworth, Billy Bob Thornton, Bruce Dern, and his name is covered, but I'm pretty sure that's John Malkovich in Cut Bank. So this looks great, but I've never heard of it. So this is most of these were blind buys anyway. So I picked up a lottery ticket. heard a little bit about this film. Had it on DVD, never watched it. I'm like, might as well upgrade the Blu-ray. Has the slipcover. Then I got another movie I never heard of. And I'm not sure I know the guy. Henry Rollins is in The Last Heist. It's a pretty cool design cover-wise, but it's definitely one of those low-budget movies, and it's a heist movie, so I'm not sure how good it is. So I'll be interested in seeing that eventually. This is the remake of Arthur. I would probably prefer to see the original Arthur first, but I don't know if that's on Blu-ray or not. But I was like, this comes with a slipcover, might as well. Cheap. This one kind of confused me slipcover-wise, but the movie is called Faster. But for some reason, the slipcover, it says Vitesse Extreme, which I think is French. Yeah, it looks like they got the French version, because the English is the second language. Thought that was cool. Slipcover one. Does this come with English? Please tell me it comes with English. Okay, it comes with the English version. But the French one is put first. So this is probably from an HMV in Montreal, and they shipped it to the downtown store in Toronto. Neighbors 2. I wanted to see the first one. I never saw any of them. Now I have to try and find the first one for cheap. But, you know, I got the second one. Purge. Election Year. Which is the third one. I kind of wanted to get the first and second one, but I couldn't find it. And so now I have to try and find the first and second one when it's cheap. But, you know, this one kind of looked like it was the best out of all of them. Like, just trailer-wise. I haven't seen any of them. This was a unique find. This is the last Blu-ray that I have that I got from HMV. The price tag was a little ridiculous, I think. But considering the cast and the fact that it was like 85% off, I'm like, that really expensive price tag is not expensive anymore. So I picked up Freeheld. I only slightly heard about this movie, and then when I saw it on the shelf, in the wrong section, I might add, when I found it, I remembered the film when it came out. But I didn't remember the cast. And you got Ellen Page, Julianne Moore, Michael Shannon, and Steve Carell. I'm like, yes. And apparently it comes with the Academy Award-winning short documentary. So I am definitely excited in seeing this film. Awesome. And it came with the slipcover. I'm happy. Because if I bought all the movies I bought from HMV when it was closing, and I bought them at full price, it would have been way over
9,000! What, 9,000? There's no way that could be right!
I saved a lot. I saved a lot. Anyways, now for the moment you've all been waiting for. I kind of wanted something big to remember HMV by. Something that I would kind of would want, and it turned out HMV had the thing that just sort of hit on so many levels. Not only it's so absolutely Canadian, as well as remembers HMV and all that. Like it's a big item. I had to carry this from Young and Dundas all the way to my house in Mississauga. When I went for the last time for HMV, it was on the third last day. So it was, I believe, Wednesday. Yes, it was Wednesday. Because Good Friday was the last day that store will be open. And now it's closed. So I picked up... Here we go. Are you ready for this? I want to make sure the reveal is right. Here we go. I'm a little bit excited because I'm actually controlling the camera as I'm doing this. Okay, here we go. I picked up Scott Pilgrim vs. the World poster. Now, it's not just any poster. It is wood. Not only is it that, but I don't know if you can tell, but it is signed by
Edgar Wright himself, as well as the original graphic novel Canadian cartoonist, Brian O'Malley, I believe I got that name right, and Ellen Wong, the actress, who plays Knive Chow in the movie. That's really cool. I think it's really cool. And I'm definitely going to be selling my other Scott Pilgrim vs. the World poster. And the only downside is HMV probably had this hanging up in either a back room or somewhere on the wall. And even though the backing had to put it on the wall, you just put it on that little latch, they decided to screw it in on all the corners. Or 6 holes in total, 3 on each side. But other than that, it's in decent condition. The signature of Edgar Wright is a little bit faded in, though. And Ellen's signature is getting a little bit faded, too. But the Brian O'Malley one is definitely really clear.
Yeah, I'm going to miss HMV a lot more than I miss Future Shop and Blockbuster. And I mean, HMV is still in the US and HMV is still in the UK. So whenever I visit those two countries, I'll definitely make sure I take a trip to HMV. So that ends my HMV My Buys Part 5. Thank you very much for watching. Subscribe for more. And I want you to have a nice day or night or whatever time you watch this. Have a nice whatever. Thank you again for watching.